sit right on the top of the edge of my shoe. That way I don't chop my ankle off. Building this. That one should have went, it didn't go. So we're gonna go ahead and move back from it just a little bit and catch it, I hope. Yep. And that's a razored edge. Need to get back up here closer to me. Get down too low. This is the problem spot we had on the reverse. So taking a few smaller chips to move that edge up closer to this hump, because that's where that fracture that was originally on that side of the rock, and I crushed the platform, which didn't help. Is so I've got to move my edge a little bit more and strengthen it up. Try to come back through there. I haven't built one of these since the four-wheeler accident I had. And my back is feeling it like you would not believe it. Well, you can kind of see there's a little line here from where I hit before trying to take this lump off. It's just kind of a half moon, which was where I was trying to drive the flake through before, and it didn't go because it was trying to take too much mass off. So I will go ahead and come in from the ends again and try to make sure I keep bending those down too. At this point, either end could be the tip end. So it's how the rock basically acts and reacts to what I'm taking off with flakes. This one spot is really the thick kind of do or die thing of the rock, but the problem of it is I got this end thin, I need this end thinner, because it's really, really thick. I'm trying to hold it at that angle with that lump on there. It's not really the easiest thing to try to do. It's going to take some alternate flaking to go around that end to thin it out of there. there's only so much you can do on the end, so you don't want to hit it directly down it like you're going to flute it, but it's easier coming in from the sides. Hopefully, at the right angle, you get most of that to come off of there. Get that lump down there. That one curled completely around and down the center of it. So it removed a little bit more mass. Make sure your leather's on there. You don't want a chopped up leg. Could end up with a chopped up finger that time. Okay, we're working on a little bit of a false flake there. I'll probably go ahead and just tap off there. I don't have to worry about that, but this edge here is a razor. So, let's go ahead. Set up a little bit of a platform there. And take that little thing off there. We don't have to worry about that. Dull the edge. Let's see. Okay, I like the way that one's coming into play. This one here needs a little bit more thin down over here. Probably could change it angle just a little bit. Edge is a little bit sharp over here yet. Try to grab my finger. better. And since this lump's right here in the middle of this thing, I ain't real worried about it too much, because the middle of the blade on this thing is thinner than the ends of it, actually, when it's completed. So I might have to take a few thinner flakes, but I'm also shaping this as I'm grinding the edge off, or shearing the edge off, as they call it. This edge actually is too thick here to really drive back this way, so I'm going to have to take a flake off of it this way to go shorter with them. Try to get that angle to where I can come back across the top. There is a little bit of shattered material there, so it's going to be a little bit more difficult to get the flakes to come off a little cleaner. But decreasing your angle of the edge should, unless I really smacked it way too wrong and put way too many fractures in it, should clean it up enough to where I can get somewhat of a bang in there to get some of it off of it. Okay. Now that that one's gone, I'm going to go ahead and come back and look at this guy. Ooh, actually it's really fun. Definitely getting down there. There is a little bit of a fracture here, but I'm not too worried about it. It's still, meaning I can still work with it. This one here, I can take that one off, and it should go out their ways, but I think I'll take this one and this one off before I try that one, or at least from that end. Never hurts to prepare your edge a little bit. Make sure it's not going to chop your fingers off before you grab onto it. Take this lump out of my pocket. I think, believe it's my wallet. And I don't want it to hit a Leatherman. So that's always nice to get the lumps out before you actually start. But if you're going to drive a flake through, make sure it's through your wallet before it gets to you. That one crushed, but I caught it from the side a little bit. I'll go back and try to catch it a little bit more from that other side. Okay, sometimes you wish it was glued on. Okay, this thing's starting to go into shape a little bit more. I don't have to drive them plates clear across, but I can go ahead and trim them up to where the edge is coming back into play again. Man, we got a dust devil going by in the neighbor's yard. Kind of glad it was over there instead of over here.